Welcome to my channel. It's me, Rhonda, also known as the Sparkly One. Today I have a cute crochet project for you. I hope you know how to crochet because this is going to be really, really fun. And it's pretty quick and super cute and very easy and cozy and comfy. My husband bought me a pair of boots for Christmas and I was so happy and I was like, yay, I can make some boot cuffs. So I would like to show you how to make these. All you're going to need is some yarn and a crochet hook. This is just worsted weight yarn. You can buy it at Walmart. Get your favorite color. Grab a crochet hook. This is a size J, like a 6 millimeter. You can get an H, an I, a J, or a K. I think that would be really suitable for this project. So grab your yarn and let's get started. What you're gonna do to start your project is to make a slip knot. So all you have to do is wrap your yarn around your fingers, pull this line across the middle, and then put your crochet hook up underneath to make a slip knot onto your hook. Then you're gonna chain two, so you're gonna wrap your yarn around, twice. So you're gonna have two single crochets. You're gonna wrap your yarn around your hook, insert into this one next to the knot, put two strands on your hook, and then yarn over and pull through. Yarn over, pull through one. Yarn over, pull through three. What we're gonna be making is a foundation half double crochet. So instead of making a long strand of chains and then going back into it to make half double crochets, you're gonna do it all in one step. And this is what I'm showing you today. So you yarn over, you go into this base right here, you're gonna put two strands on top of your hook, you're gonna yarn over, you're gonna pull through, yarn over, pull through one, yarn over, pull through three. Yarn over, go into that chain at the bottom, two strands on top, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through one, yarn over, pull through three. Yarn over, go into that base down here, put two strands on top, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through one, which now you can kind of see what we're doing. We have a chain down here and a half double up here. It's all in one step. So how easy is that? That is so fun, so quick. You're going to be so happy that you learned this. It took me 50 years to find this. So yarn over, go into this base down here. So you see these chains right here? That's what you're going to be working in, this one chain. So it's always your last chain that you left. Yarn over, pull through one. Yarn over, pull through one. See the difference here? That's a chain and that's not. Then you're going to yarn over, pull through three for your half double. So let me show you that from this direction. So right here, you're going to have one, two, three, four. This is already five half double crochets. So you're going to need approximately, I'm going to say 28 to 38, depending on how big the area is that you want to wrap around on your leg. So it might be an ankle, it might be a calf, or it might be right below the knee. So mine is going to go right below the knee. I'm going to make, I think 32 or 34 stitches. It doesn't have to be exact as long as it measures around your leg. And then what you'll do is you'll join it, and then we're gonna go ahead and start this part after we connect this part. So go ahead and measure your leg after you get a certain amount of stitches. Say you get up to 30 and then measure your leg, and then always make sure that it's an even number because otherwise it won't work as far as having these ribbed edges right here. So an even number of these around your leg, and meet me back here and I will show you how to join. I have 32 stitches on my hook. And a lot of times when you're making these in other tutorials, they'll join from this direction in the front. But for some reason, for me, it's just so much easier to turn my work to the back. And then you'll have two strands, one on each side, hanging from the bottom. Then what you're gonna do is you're gonna go into this chain right here at the top, of your work at the beginning, take your yarn, wrap it around, pull it through. That will join your work without twisting. If I did it the other way, somehow I get so confused and it always twists. So if I just do it from the back, it's perfectly fine. It works out great. Then you're just going to take this and you're going to flip it. So that's how it was, hanging like that. Flip it around. So now you'll have this opening right here. Now we can do this later. It doesn't have to be now. You can snug it up a little bit right here. But we're going to join this later. So it needs to be joined right here. If you want to do it now, that's perfectly fine. I just don't want to take the time to do it when I know I have to weave in ends at the top. So I kind of just want to do it all together. So this is what your work will look like, and you can just go ahead and start working on it. So we're going to make this ribbed part right here. This is what we're working on next. So our base is already done. We're going to work on the ribbed part. Chain three. And then what we're going to start are our double crochets. All of your chain threes will count as a double crochet. So right above this stitch right here is where they'll be. So you're not going to count this first space right here because this is actually allowing for that space. So what you're going to do is you're going to chain three, yarn over, go into this next stitch right here. Go under both of the strands, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two. So now you have what's considered two double crochets. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to make these as post because we're going to start a front post and a back post double crochet. So what you're going to do now is you're going to double crochet in all of the stitches around the boot cuff. So yarn over, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two. Yarn over, go into the next stitch, pull through two, pull through two. Yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two. So you're going to do that all the way around. Those are double crochets, and we are making a post to start the ribbed stitch. So go ahead and do that, and I'll show you what the next step is after you get that all done. When you've gone into that last space right there, you'll see that you have this chain three space. So you're going to count three, one, two, three stitches, because that's your chain. You're going to go in the top of that chain, and you're going to put your hook in there, yarn over, and then you're going to pull through, and that's a slip stitch. Now what you're going to be doing at this point is chaining three again, and you're always going to have chain threes on top of chain threes. So this post right here will never get worked into. It's always going to stay the same. But all the other ones you're going to yarn over, and this post right here you're going to go in between and pick it up from the front to the back and go around and do another double crochet. So now you have two double crochets. Yarn over. This is going to be a back post crochet. So instead of going this way and coming from the front, you're going to yarn over, put your hook to the back, bring it through and push that post to the back, yarn over, bring it up, yarn over, pull through two, pull through two. Then you're going to yarn over, and this is a front post. You're going to pick it up from the front, yarn over, do a double crochet, and the next one you're going to yarn over. This is a back post. You're going to push that post to the back. You're going to yarn over, pull up, do a double crochet. The next one is a front post. Go down here, pull it up, do a double crochet. Whoops. Yep, that happens a lot. Yarn over, pull through. Pull through two, pull through two. So that's a double crochet. So do you see every other one is what you're doing? So then this is going to be a back one. You yarn over, you pull through, do a double crochet. The next one, yarn over, go to the front, pull through. The next one, double crochet, go through the back, pull through two, pull through two. So there you go. You see that? That's making that rib stitch. So go ahead and do that all the way around. Don't go into this last one right here, this chain three. That's always going to be left alone. So let's go ahead and meet at the end, and then I'll show you how to join at the top. And then we're going to continue with 10 rows or 8 to 10 rows, depending on how thick you want.
Here you are
at the end of your second row. And if you had the even number of stitches, it should work out exactly like this one. And so here's your chain three space. So you're going to go into the top of that chain three space again. You're going to slip stitch your row together. Let's go ahead and finish our 8 to 10 rows, depending on how thick you want it. So this is the comparison. We're going to make another foundation row right here at the top. Then you can leave it like that if you want, which is totally cute. It's adorable. Or you can add this scalloped edge. So I'm going to show you how to do this. So let's get this part done, and then we can start on that. So go ahead and do that and continue the video, and we'll have some fun. When you're at the end of this row, you chain three, you yarn over, and you're always going to be going under that first one right there, that first front post double crochet. That's always going to start your round. So yarn over and then do the back, double crochet, yarn over, do the front, double crochet, and then continue all the way around. Keep connecting with your chain threes, and then we will see you when you get all those rows finished. Now I have 8 rows on my boot cuff, and I think 8 is all I'm gonna need because my yarn is a little bit thicker than some of them. Some yarns are thicker than others, so it depends on your yarn. So at this point, we're gonna go ahead and make the band that's at the bottom at the top. We're gonna make the half double crochet at the top. So with a half double crochet, you're gonna chain two. Then you're gonna yarn over, and you'll be going into this stitch right here. So not this stitch right there, because this is attached to this one. But you're gonna yarn over, you're gonna go underneath this chain right here that's on top of this ribbing right here. You're gonna yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through three. So that's a half double crochet. So this counts as your first one, and this is your second one. Again, you're gonna yarn over, you're gonna go right here to this stitch under there, pull through three stitches. Yarn over, go into this stitch next to it, yarn over, pull through three. So you see we're making that band that's at the bottom at the top. Yarn over, go into that next stitch, yarn over, pull through three. So you're going to go ahead and do that all the way around, and then we're going to join at the top, and then we're going to start on the scalloped edge. We're here at the end. We're gonna join in a second, but I just wanted to show you where to go into that last stitch. So you're just gonna go right there, do your half double, and then it will be right next to that chain three, or chain two, excuse me, the chain two. So you're gonna join at the top of the chain two here to join your row. So that's a slip stitch. So as you can see, if you just want to leave it just like this, that's totally fine. It looks cute this way too. And you can just cut this, weave in the end, weave in this end, and then you'll be all done and just make your other boot cuff. But we're going to move on to the scalloped edge. With the scalloped edge, what you're going to do is you're going to start out with a half double crochet in the same stitch that you're in. So instead of going into that stitch next to it, you'll be going into the same hole of the first stitch. So you're gonna yarn over, you're gonna go into that hole right there, you're gonna yarn over, you're gonna pull through three. So that's a half double crochet as part of your scallop. Then you're gonna do three double crochets in that same hole. So just keep working in there. So you're going to do three double crochets, one, two, pull out my yarn, and then three. So it's all in that same space. See how it's starting to form? Then you're going to do a half double crochet. So you're making a little pattern. So you're just doing a half double crochet, three double crochets, and a half double crochet. So it's fanning it out, a little scallop. Then you're going to skip a stitch. So you're going to go one, two. So in that second stitch, you're going to go underneath. You're going to pull this through, and you're going to pull through again. So you're making a slip stitch to secure it in that space right there. Then your next stitch, you're going to yarn over. You're going to make another half double crochet like you did on this first scallop. So half double crochet, three double crochets, half double crochet. But what you're going to do is you're going to go into this next stitch after this stitch right here. So just go in there, make a half double crochet. Then, like I said, the three doubles. One, two, three, and the half double crochet. Then you're going to skip a stitch, go into that second one, you're going to secure it with a slip stitch. So there you have two. It's starting to look really, really feminine. I love it. So you're going to go into the next stitch with your half double, then your three doubles, and then your half double. One, two, three, and then your half double. And then secure it with a slip stitch in the second chain at the top right there. And then there you go. So do that all the way around. I'll show you right at the end on how you can join this part, okay? Here we are at the end. And I'm going to be making my last scallop. So I'm yarning over. I'm going into the next stitch, which is right here. And I'm working all of my stitches in the same hole right there, the same stitch. So I have a half double in there, two doubles. This is my third double crochet. And my last half double crochet. So now what you'll do is you're going to be left with this space right here. So you're going to see the base of this scallop right here. There's a spot right there. You're just going to put your hook in there and you're going to slip stitch right to that next one. Just snug up your work, pull up a little bit of a tail, put your hook down, and then you can kind of fluff it out and see how it looks. So see, look at it, joined perfectly. Everything looks great. I know you're gonna love this. It's so adorable. And this is where you're just gonna cut this and you're gonna take a hook or a needle with a big eye on it and you're gonna thread this and you're gonna weave it in and out of these areas inside of the boot cuff. And then you'll just cut the end so it doesn't show. But just cut this here, get a needle or your crochet hook and just weave it inside at the top through there. What you'll do is you'll cut this right here, pull out your yarn, and then this piece that's left, you'll take a needle with a bigger eye. So this is a yarn needle or a tapestry needle, something like that. And you'll just put it between your fingers here, pinch the yarn. I don't know if you can see that, hopefully. And you just slide your yarn in there and pull it through. So you don't have to try to thread it. Just take your needle and just start weaving it inside of the different stitches on your boot cuff. Then you just turn it to the inside and then you're just going to weave it in and out of these stitches. So you'll just keep going underneath all of those stitches. Whoops. And you can do that, which is fine. I mean, the needle came off, but you could just cut it here and it should be totally fine. Or you can just re-thread your needle and pull it through and then go ahead and finish weaving in your ends. And you'll be all finished. This is what it will look like when it's all done and all the ends are weaved in. So you can't even tell. Anyway, happy crocheting. Make them in your favorite colors. You're gonna be so excited. You can give them as gifts. They're so adorable. Look at that. Thanks for joining me. I hope you have a wonderful day. Don't forget to share and like and subscribe to my channel. God bless you guys. Bye.